The concentration of intellectual expertise in this area between Baltimore and Washington is really phenomenal. And I will say from my own perspective, having been in the area for almost 30 years, has really helped to create the opportunity to develop personal relationships with program officers at all the different federal funding agencies. If they need a question answered, if they want to see something, they pick up the phone and say, can we come out for a visit? And the answer is always, absolutely. Let us know when you'll be here and we'll roll out the red carpet. But it has really been helpful in terms of securing funding, and I think it's also been very helpful in terms of these discussions, which oftentimes take place in an more of an informal setting, in helping to plant seeds about how to shape this field and where it should go and what the priorities should be. And so, I feel like I've been incredibly fortunate to have had the opportunity to do that. And Dr. Kerwin mentioned the empowering initiative, and I'm very encouraged to see that one of the pillars of this new initiative is in the area of biomedical informatics and imaging, which speaks to the need to put all of this data together, not just DNA sequence data, but lots of different kinds of data, patient data, from medical records, from images, and to put all of this together to get a much more holistic view of health and disease. I just want to make the point that across the UMB campus, we have tried to be highly collaborative, as Dr. Perman noted. And we have collaborations underway with colleagues in essentially every school of the campus. And these are ways in which our very small faculty can really participate in much broader research efforts and hopefully bring our expertise to others who wouldn't necessarily have access to it otherwise. We also try very hard to extend our collaborations and partnerships beyond the campus, not only locally, in the region, doing some work with Baltimore City Health Department on women's health issues for underserved populations. We've also been working with colleagues at UMSES and other Maryland institutions to try and develop a research agenda to use genomics to study the health of the Chesapeake Bay. And globally, we've had some fabulous collaborations with colleagues in Novartis Vaccines, as an example, using genomic information to develop new vaccines against infectious agents, tapping into the power of genomics to identify new targets that previously didn't exist. And we've also played some very important roles, I think, in responding to a number of public health crises, particularly related to infectious disease. As I mentioned before, the anthrax attacks in 2001, the cholera outbreak in Haiti in 2010 following the earthquake there, and a very large E. coli outbreak in Germany last year. And all of these projects have been carried out with international collaborators.